You're watching UNICEF television. Scooping just enough water to sustain life is the daily challenge for everyone in Kerio Center Village, children included. In one of the worst drought-affected areas of northern Kenya, the water from this dry riverbed is salty and fluoride contaminated, but it is all they have. Eight-year-old Konzi Atabo tells us she's been making the daily water trip since her mother came down with malaria. At her home, we find her lying sick.
The water we get is very bad, and it brings us sickness and diarrhea because it is not very clean.
Like other families here, from relative financial security with more than 50 goats 5 years ago, successive droughts have gradually seen their livestock dwindle to nothing, especially during this year's crisis. But hope for this village is on its way, thanks to a 17-kilometer pipeline that will be powered by windmill, being built with support from UNICEF that will connect to a local river, guaranteeing a water supply to the village, including its newly built secondary school. With the same goal of building community resilience in times of drought, this agricultural project challenges traditional reliance on livestock and grazing by teaching newer, more reliable ways of growing food.
What is happening is that year in, year out, drought is coming in, destroying the livestock they have.
Projects that make a difference and building for the long term.
We need to immediately put in place measures for recovery, resilience, and work more intensively in disaster risk reduction. Otherwise, we are going to see the disparities widening between the haves and have-nots.
Back at the village of Kerio, the prospect of a reliable water supply and everything that represents cannot come soon enough.
The fresh water we can even use for planting trees, for drinking.
And for the children whose lives are dominated by the daily chore of water collection, it means the chance of a childhood where little chance has existed before. This is Rob McBride reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, go to unicef.org. Unite for children.